Now, there's a bipartisan support network out there for a lot of these technologies, at least I hope there is. We need to continually cultivate that, but it's becoming more and more bipartisan, as it should. None of us are escaping the impact of carbon pollution and greenhouse gases. Many of us want to add jobs to the economy, and significant paying jobs at that. And none of us wants to destroy the well-being and the health and well-being of our constituents. And we certainly understand the challenge offered each and every one of us to hand over the environment in a better state than that which we inherited, so that the next generations can prosper from our work. So we're united in that common cause. Make no mistake about it, there is an across-the-board policy impact by the work that you do. And it's incredibly important for us as we witness removal from the Paris Accord, which I suggest is a very poor decision. It's a scar across our image to the world, and it's one that speaks of lack of commitment and a denouncement of trust for our country. We brought people to that table. How dare we leave in the midst of the work? And we know that states and cities and regions across this country will pick up that unfinished business. But we do know that the best strategy was for us to be committed as a nation, as we ought to be. And so it's important for us, however possible, to continue to do the good work that can keep us involved in this innovation economy. Someone is going to produce in the manufacturing sector a lot of the byproducts that are required in this innovation transfer. And had we been at the table, that was the best opportunity for us to grow those jobs. Make no mistake about it, you're doing it in your own individual way, in your collective way, and that speaks resoundingly well of each and every one of you, and it heightens and showcases your professionalism. We know that in order for us to continue forward with the introduction of energy efficiency and renewables as an innovation, as a triumvirate, if you will, of improvement that must come, that can grow jobs, that is important. We see energy efficiency as the fuel of choice. No matter what the compilation of the pile of generation that we require as a society is, it's important for us to be resourceful, to make certain that however we utilize those electrons, it must be done in a very efficient and effective way. And that begins with generation. Efficiency with generation, efficiency with transmission and distribution, efficiency with consumption. And when we do that, there's room for a lot of product development, is there not? You know, you witness it all the time and you produce it all the time, and that's what this fair is about. So I applaud the public information that is part of your networking with us here on the Hill. But to go forward, for us to commit to an all-of-the-above strategy for energy, we must be all-of-the-above with the resources that we require, R&D. Many of you, I wouldn't be surprised to hear, have networked with EERE or with ARPA-E. We've worked to strengthen those programs, to advance them in even better stead, to offer more assistance and not just drop you midway. And so those dynamics are important. But if we're going to continue to go forward, let's invest in that research so that we can grow and cultivate even additional jobs that will respond to the efforts. You know, with grid modernization, with the focus on grid, with battery storage as a potential, we then add to the durability, the predictability, the certainty of our renewable resources. That's important. And I think we will see monumental improvements coming in that regard. We need to go forward and champion the causes of research to make certain that we don't stop with the progress. And especially since we pulled out of that Paris Accord, we need to make certain that we're doing everything we can to keep pace with what is a fast pace on the international scene. And then finally, I would suggest to you that the Feds should be a partner. I think that, you know, if we're going to leave it to the states to do their thing, if we've abandoned this national commitment via the Paris Accord, then do not let us interrupt the markets and subsidize power that is inefficient or polluted. Let's not choose players here and reward them via payments that will subsidize and disrupt the market. So we know that it works when we have a sound energy and environment agenda, where renewables, especially with the development coming in storage, become more and more the go-to. And you know, the research that can come, the commitment that needs to be made to wind power, for example, larger turbines, making certain improvements come with efficiency, not only with the product delivery, but with placement delivery, with history already embedded well into the years now, we have a track record from which to work. So to make the efficiency within wind all the more powerful. Solar, when you do all of that research and the thin film development, when you make those solar panels all the more efficient, when we work together to make certain that we accompany that with sound storage, that element of reform is made all the stronger, and so we go forward. But to allow FERC or some groups to intercept and denounce some of the improvements we can make, where we interrupt the flow in states that are choosing to go more green, that are choosing to go to energy efficiency and to renewables, we shouldn't disrupt the market. Yes, there will be weak pockets in the market. Yes, there will be certain challenges to grid modernization. But if we commit, as the president should and as Congress should, to an innovation economy that allows all of us to have the benefits of new introduction of ideas, of innovation, of renewables, of storage, of efficiency, of research, we will then continue to empower this economy and be able to compete effectively on an international scale. But because we withdrew from Paris Accord, I would hope our commitments would be all the more deeply rooted to make a difference, to enable you to continue to dream and envision and empower with your magic, with your professionalism, with your intellect, with your tremendous opportunity to power with one another, to come together in these wonderful conglomerates that enable you to learn from each other, and to do those programs at the federal level that truly support the work that you do. I saw it when I was energy chair at the New York State Assembly. My last 15 years of my 25 in service there were as energy chair. I then left to run what I think is a very respected organization in the New York State Energy Research and Development Authority. I served as president and CEO. I saw what happened when we provided the underpinnings of support for research, when we did the portfolio management situation in a way that brought more and more clean, green power into play. These are the things we can do as a nation. And step aside if you're not going to be visionary. Step aside if you want to still hold on to those friends that are empowering your politics and your political pocketbook. Step aside because we have people that want to do it in an ingenious way, do it in a very intellectual way, and a caring way that provides for efficiency, that grows a cleaner environment, addresses public health, and grows jobs. Thank you all for being here today, and look forward to working with you again.